वेलकम फ्रेंड्स इन साइंस लेक्चर 3 लेसन 15 आवर एनवायरनमेंट। टुडेज टॉपिक वी हैव टेकन एज हाउ डू आवर एक्टिविटीज अफेक्ट द एनवायरनमेंट। सो वी नो दैट बेटर एक्टिविटीज ऑब्वियसली डू बेटरमेंट फॉर द एनवायरनमेंट, पर जनरली ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज विच आर एक्चुअली वेरी सेल्फिश टूवर्ड्स देम इज मेकिंग द एनवायरनमेंट very in bad condition, that is polluting our environment. So our activities are basically polluting the environment, and which is leading to some of the factors, in which the one factor is depletion of ozone, and the biggest problem is waste disposal. These are the one few factors which we are trying to deal with at present. So ozone depletion is an important topic that we are going to take for today. So what is an ozone is? Ozone is a oxygen molecule only, but it is O3. This is an O3 molecule, that's why this is called as an ozone. A molecule formed by 3 atoms of oxygen. While O2 that we are taking and breathing as oxygen, this is O2 only, which is normally referred as an oxygen that we are taking from the environment towards our lungs. But basically, if we breathe ozone is deadly poisonous. So thanks to God that ozone is not there at the lower bottom of our environment, that is atmosphere. It is on very high altitude, that is, it is in stratosphere. First is in troposphere, then it is in stratosphere. So it is approximately from about 30 kilometers from our environment, and it's a big layer of certain meters. And this converts performs the functions there, and it is very poisonous, but it is not at the lower bottom, so it is not affecting us or any other organisms on the earth. So it is at the higher level. But what is happening to that higher level of the atmosphere, that ozone performs the essential function. These are in very, very necessity. Ozone is there, and what you see as an atmosphere as an above is due to ozone only. It shields the surface of the earth from ultraviolet radiation from the sun. So the UV rays that we take, UV means ultraviolet radiation rays, which are coming from these many types of formation of wavelengths are coming from the sun. But out of that, one is an ultraviolet. So these ultraviolet radiations is stopped and not allowed to reach towards the earth's surface by this ozone. So ozone is kind of a shield which is stopping and not allowing to reach towards us. So what is happening? It is highly damaging to organisms. For example, that is causing skin cancer in human beings. So if this ozone directly reaches to the earth, it will be absorbed by our skin and going to create a lot of problems. Now, how this ozone works at that particular level? So basically it is O2 only. 50% O2 is always present there, and 50% it will be ozone. Now as the sunlight falls from the ozone, it breaks down into free oxygen, or we use the word as an free oxygen, or actually it is called as a nascent oxygen, not mentioned in your book, but learn out. So free oxygen. So this free oxygen is very, very, very highly unstable by its nature. And this free oxygen immediately reacts with another O2 molecule in instability, because oxygen is only present. This nascent oxygen is very less in amount. So immediately this free oxygen or a nascent oxygen reacts with O2, and O2 turns with free oxygen turns to O3. So by taking ultraviolet radiation, this has broken down, and this broken down is reacting with O2 and turn to ozone. And this is also very unstable by its nature. Ozone immediately breaks down from, this is a reverse cycle. O3 again breaks down into free oxygen and O2. And this free oxygen of like two of them immediately reacts together and turn to O2. So it's a reverse cycle, and another releasing this ultraviolet radiation back to the atmosphere. So this ozone helps by absorbing ultraviolet radiations, turning to O3. And this O3 again breaks down by releasing ultraviolet radiation back towards the space and turning to O2. This is how it stops not reaching this ultraviolet radiations towards the earth. Now what we do, we enter as a villain here, and what we do, that we have synthetic chemicals we are releasing in the atmosphere like CFC, chlorofluorocarbons, used in refrigerators, fire extinguishers, AC, and many other equipments. Mean are these equipments, refrigerators, AC, and fire extinguishers. So all the cars are having AC, houses are having ACs, refrigerators are present everywhere on the earth. So these are releasing a very high amount of CFC, because this is a CFC is a coolant field inside. And this United Nation in 87 has stopped this program, that not to be filled. And it took some years of time for freezing. UNP, that is the United Nation Environmental Program, has succeeded in forging an agreement to freeze CFC. So they have stopped this CFC, and now this CFC is not being used. It is HFC. HFC is used. Hydrofluorocarbons are used. HFC. If you open your car bonnets, and you will be able to see HFC written there, 134A. So this is a basic gas which has been filled, 134A, hydrofluorocarbon. This is no more depleting ozone and friendly towards the environment, though it is causing global warming, but still it is not damaging this, so we are happy for that. So this is how depletion of ozone is caused. So if you are using older refrigerators, please stop it. And you may transform and switch towards the new one, or refill this gas by from CFC to HFC. That can be done. Managing the garbages. This is a new one. You may understand we are having a big problem how to manage these garbages, and the litter is thrown everywhere. So this is the biggest issue at present. So even the Gujarat government is trying to, at present situation, is trying to manage this garbage and convert into electricity and many different processes, but we see we are dumping this in narrow highway towards going furthermore. On an highway we see a kind of a rock, a mountain is being built of this all dumping waste, and this is happening on within every city. So what is basically happening, that some of this waste material can be broken down by the environment, that is an enzymes. So what we eat also is broken down in our stomach by then enzymes. Yes, so what we learned, that is enzymes does break down everything that we eat. So as I told you that what we are eating, it is an broken down by enzymes which are present in our stomach. So basically they are exon specific, that means they specific enzymes are needed to break down a particular substance. That means if you want to break down lipids, so lipase enzymes is required, fats if you want to break down, so our special enzymes are required for fats, proteins, so that can be protease, can be an enzyme to break down these proteins, right? The vitamins are proteins only, so likewise the certain enzymes are built for a specific action to break down certain molecule, like in you have been taught in that in mouth we are having amylase enzymes to break down starch. So a specific action is needed for a specific function to happen, which is done by specific enzymes. Now that is why we will not get any energy if we eat coal, because these enzymes are not present inside. Even the paper also, sometimes you see that the cows and buffaloes are eating paper, so they are happy eating paper, but we are not able to eat this paper. But because it is made from the cellulose of the plants. Cellulose of the plants we are not capable of digesting, because we are not having cellulase enzymes present in our body. But these cows and buffaloes are having it, so they are able to digest this paper also. Fine, so they are happy by eating paper. It is not that, but this chemicals which are going is harmful for them. Now human made material like plastic will not be broken down by action of bacteria and other saprophytes. But the problem is residing with this plastic. The huge dump of plastic which we are doing it is getting accumulated inside on the earth surface, which is not getting decomposed, because their fungus and many other bacteria are also not capable. Saprophytes are dead acting organisms which are not capable of breaking down this plastic material, which is man-made. Fine, it is not a natural thing. So it persists for a long time. Long time means it lasts for lakhs of years, millions of years, and which is a dangerous thing. And it is not allowing the water also to go down, so which is creating another problem, that is the water levels are dropping down. So this is a big problem. Even the plants cannot grow because this is not allowing for the soil fertility to transfer. This is plastic is a blockage kind of a thing. So substances are not broken down biological by the biological process, that is by these enzymes, are called as biodegradable. That can be broken down. If they are capable of these enzymes are capable of breaking down these organic substances, that is biological substances, though this process is called as formation of the substance is called as biodegradable formation, that can be broken down by the enzyme. But substances which are not capable of breaking, it means they cannot be broken down by a specific enzymes also, action also, by any enzymes which are living on the earth, these are called as bio non-degradable substances, like plastic. Glass is not biodegradable, so it remains on the earth for a very long time. So these are problematic things. Glass is a problematic thing, plastic is a problematic thing, fine. And so these are the problems which are getting created for us because we are making more and more of these substances nowadays. And other things which are biodegradable can be easily broken down. So they, like any animal also die, they get degraded. So this is creating problem. So if you visit any city or town, you are able to see a dump of garbage is everywhere. In the city might be clean, and this waste materials, they say that you throw in a litter, and this litter is thrown in a particular litter areas, like wet litter and dry, and they have kept many different formations. But so you may see even the tourist place are completely filled with wafer packets and all made for the plastic, and they are not getting degraded. So this is a big problem now, that what to do. That's why the government is trying to stop these plastic bags and all, which are very thin, because they burnt off while making. But the larger bags and the thick bags can be used multiple times also, and they can be recycled also. So this is the one thing that can be done, that we use if you want to use only that, there is no chance of using any other thing. So they can be recycled. So the plastic made should be slightly thick of its size. Fine. So this plays an important role, how we change this, our disposable things and packing materials. Fine. These are packing materials which we are using, and disposable things that we are using. So instead of sometimes using disposable things, we can use certain things that can be washed off also, like steel plates and all. Nowadays we are using a very large amount of disposal, which is creating a huge junk. So that can be slightly stopped by using certain thing, or a good option can be made out of it, that it can be formed into biodegradable formation. Fine. So we can think about this, that government is also putting pressure on keeping paper cups, like, so paper cups, instead of using plastic cups of tea, that is common drink in Ahmedabad. So that is a common thing that can be changed. So the paper cups are biodegradable, so that can help our environment. Even the nowadays we are making this instead of disposable things from the big plants, this crush has been made, and the plates are made from the cellulose material of the plants. And like a paper trays are made for instead of disposable thermocol or plastic plates. So if we eat in them, and if we sometimes throw also, if we throw it also, it will be not creating any kind of junkyard, because this is going to get this decomposed by the cellulose material. And this, because it is a cellulose, it can be decomposed, and even can be, if it is eaten by the other animals also, it will not harm them. So we can target something and make a formation that is environmental friendly. So I hope so that you grow more plants and switch on to certain things which is environmental friendly by your own self. Thank you for this particular video.